सो हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई विल बी गिविंग यू रिविजन ऑफ फ्यू चैप्टर्स फ्रॉम 12th स्टैंडर्ड, योर सेकेंड ईयर सिलेबस. सो फर्स्ट स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम सोल्यूशन. सोल्यूशन इज ए होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर. सोल्यूशन इज ए होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर ऑफ टू और मोर कंपोनेंट्स, ऑफ टू और मोर कंपोनेंट्स. सो हियर वी हैव टू स्टडी ओनली बाइनरी सोल्यूशन. सो वॉट आर बाइनरी सोल्यूशन? ए सोल्यूशन कंटेनिंग two components. So binary solutions are those solutions which contains two components. So contain two components. Two components. A ternary solution is such a solution which contains three components. Or but in our syllabus only we have to focus on binary solution. Okay. So solute plus solvent gives solution. So on the basis of difference of solute and solvent, there are nine types of solution that you have to remember. Nine types, like gas plus gas, gas plus liquid, gas plus solid, liquid plus gas, liquid plus liquid, liquid plus solid, solid plus gas, solid plus liquid, solid plus solid. So solid plus solid involves alloy like brass, bronze, German silver, etc. Suppose gas in gas, nitrogen in oxygen. Suppose liquid in gas. Liquid in gas means chloroform in nitrogen. So like that you have to remember these nine types of solution. Now coming to the concentration units. Concentration units. So in concentration units we will discuss part volume percent, volume of A by volume of A plus volume of B into 100, mass percent, mass of A by mass of A plus mass of B into 100, part per billion or part per million ppm, weight of solute by weight of solution into 10 to the power 6, part per billion, same thing, only we have to multiply with 10 to the power 9. So when the solutes are present in very minute quantity, when the solute is present in trace quantity, then we use part per million or part per billion, generally for pollutants, like the pollutant present in atmosphere or pollutant which are present in water, causing water pollution. Next is mole fraction. Mole fraction. So mole fraction, it is the ratio of mole of one component to that of all the component present in the solution. So it is the ratio of mole of one component to that of total mole. Mole fraction of B is the mole of B upon total mole. Sum of mole fraction of all the component is unity. So here you have to take mole, not weight. So whatever weight is given, first you have to find out the mole and then you can easily find out the mole fraction. So mole fraction of all the component present in the solution is 1. Now covering molarity. Molarity. So molarity is the number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. So weight of solute by molecular mass of solute. If volume is given in milliliter, then milliliter it will be divided by 1000, that will go up. So this is molarity. Molarity is temperature dependent as it involves volume. Temperature dependent concentration unit. So it is not a very good unit to express concentration because it is temperature dependent. As we know from Charles' law, volume is directly proportional to temperature. So if temperature increases, volume increases, molarity decreases. So this you have to keep in mind. So it is a temperature dependent concentration unit. It is not a better unit to express concentration in molarity. Molarity equation is M1 V1 equal to M2 V2. Molarity of mixing is MR equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2 by V1 plus V2. This is the resultant molarity. So these formulas will be useful for you to solve numericals. Now coming to molality. So molality is the number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 kg of solvent. It is temperature independent concentration, temperature independent concentration unit. So molality is denoted by small m. Small m is n by w. In gram, if it solvent is given, then we have to divide by 1000, that will go up. So we can write weight of solute into 1000 by molecular mass of solute into weight of solvent in gram. This is the molality. It is temperature independent, so it is better unit to express concentration in molality. Like if suppose we have 2.5 gram acetic acid and it is dissolved in 75 gram benzene, so we can find molality simply number of moles. So 2.5 by upon 60, because the molar mass of acetic acid is 60. Weight of benzene, it is given in grams, so we have to divide by 1000, that will go up. So if you solve this, you will get the answer. So this will go with this. So this is 3, so it is 100 by 180. So this is 5 by 9, so 556 molal. So the molality of such a solution which has 2.5 gram of acetic acid in 75 gram of benzene is 0.556 molal. Moving to normality. Normality is number of moles of solute, number of gram equivalent of solute, number of gram equivalent of solute dissolved in V liter of solution. So for finding the number of gram equivalent, you must be aware about equivalent weight. Equivalent weight equal to atomic weight by valency. Equivalent weight equal to molecular weight by, for acid if we calculate, then it is for basicity. Basicity. So suppose equivalent weight you want to find out for base. So the base is equal to equivalent weight of base is equal to molecular weight by acidity. Suppose you want to find out equivalent weight for oxidizing agent, then molecular weight by number of electron gained per molecule. So number of electron gained per molecule. Suppose if you want to determine the equivalent weight of reducing agent, so it is molecular weight of the reducing agent by number of electron lost per molecule. Equivalent weight of salt, so it is the molecular weight of the salt by total positive or total negative, magnitude of total positive or total negative, whatever you want to take, you can take it, but you have to take only magnitude. Suppose equivalent weight of sodium carbonate, so it will be m by 2, because there is 2 positive charge or 2 negative charge. So this equivalent weight of H3PO4, it will be m by 3, because it has basicity equal to 3. Equivalent weight of H3PO3, it will be m by 2, because it has only replaceable 2. Equivalent weight of H3PO2, it will be simply equal to molecular mass. Equivalent weight of H2SO4, it will be m by 2. Equivalent weight of NaOH, it will be m, because only one OH minus ion will be replaced or it will be given in solution. So sodium hydroxide equivalent weight is m. Suppose equivalent weight we find for HCl, it will be simply m, because here only it gives one proton, so its basicity is 1. So this way you can find out the equivalent weight. Suppose if you are finding the equivalent weight of oxalic acid, anhydrous, so it will be molecular weight by 2, because it has 2 replaceable hydrogen. So this way you can find out the equivalent weight of many. If you know equivalent weight, it will be easy for you to find out normality, because normality is the number of gram equivalent of solute by V liter of solution. Coming to, suppose one question we see, 196 gram of H2SO4 is dissolved in 10 liter, is dissolved in 10 liters of solution. Find normality, find normality, find normality. So first we have to find out the number of gram equivalent. So number of gram equivalent of solute is equal to given mass. Given mass is 196 and its equivalent weight is 49, so it is 4. So normality is equal to number of gram equivalent 4 by volume, so it is 0.4 normal. So the normality of the solution having 198 gram H2SO4 in 10 liter is 0.4 normal. Normality is also temperature dependent. as it involves volume. So it is also a temperature dependent concentration unit. Equivalent weight of H2SO4 is 49, because equivalent weight of H2SO4 is m by 2, molecular mass of H2SO4 is 98, 98 by 2 is 49. So keep it in mind, H2SO4 equivalent weight is 49. Now let's see what is solubility. Solubility is the maximum amount of solute that can be dissolved at a particular amount of solvent at a particular temperature and pressure. So if we see the solubility of gas in liquid, so we will learn the Henry's law here. Henry's law. So solubility follows the rule like dissolves like. Like dissolves like. So solubility of gas in liquid obeys Henry's laws. Henry's law says that at a constant temperature, at a particular temperature, the solubility of a gas in a liquid is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas above the solution. So partial pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction of the gas. Partial pressure is equal to KH into X, where KH is called Henry's law constant. It is different for different gases and it is different for same gas at different temperature. So it is the function of the nature of the gas, that is called Henry's law constant. Henry's law constant. Looking at the like dissolves like, you must keep in mind that polar solute dissolves in polar solvent. Dissolves in polar solvent. The best polar solvent is water. The best polar solvent is water. Water is regarded as the universal solvent. And non-polar solute dissolve in non-polar solvent. Non-polar solute dissolves in non-polar solvent. Non-polar solvents are organic solvent. We can say less polar solvent like benzene, normal hexane, acetone, ether, carbon disulfide, chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, etc. Non-polar solvent. Non-polar solvent involves organic solvent like normal hexane, benzene, acetone, carbon disulfide, chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, etc. So this is the rule of solubility, that is like dissolves like. Now coming to Rawls law. Rawls law states that for a solution containing non-volatile non-electrolyte solute, the relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to mole fraction of solute. Or we can say the partial pressure in gas phase is directly proportional to mole fraction. So P equal to P1 naught into X. This is the vapor pressure in pure component. So P is equal to KHX and P is equal to P0X. So Henry's law becomes a special case when pH becomes, so P naught becomes KH, then Rawls law becomes a special case of Henry's law. So this you have to keep it in mind. Now coming to colligative properties. Such properties which depends on the number of solute particle and is independent of its nature is called colligative properties. So the properties of solution which depends on the number of solute particle and is independent of its nature is called colligative property. So it is the function of number of solute particle. It is also called democratic properties. Because in a democratic country, number of votes decide which party will form the government at the center. So it is regarded as a democratic property because it depends on number of solute particles. There are four types of colligative properties. Relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation of boiling point, depression of freezing point, osmotic pressure. So these four properties you have to keep in mind. These are, make sure that you know that vapor pressure, boiling point, freezing point, osmosis, they are not colligative property. Relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation of boiling point, depression of freezing point and osmotic pressure are colligative property. You have to keep the formula with you, P naught, P1 naught minus P1 upon P1 naught equal to X2. Elevation delta TB is equal to KB into molality. Delta TF is equal to KF into molality. And pi V equal to N KT or NRT. These are for normal condition where I went of factor is 1. If suppose of abnormality is there, abnormality in the sense that the solute dissociate or associate, then every formula will be multiplied like this. So P1 naught minus P1 upon P1 naught will become I into X2. Delta TB will become I into KB into M. Delta TF will become I into KF into M. Pi V will become I N R T. So these are the formula that will help you solve numericals. So I is Van't Hoff factor. It was given in the year 1880 by Van't Hoff. So if the solute, if I is greater than 1, that means the solute is undergoing dissociation. The solute is undergoing dissociation. If I is less than 1, the solute is undergoing association. So if I increases, that means the colligative property will increase. That means the colligative property will increase and molecular mass of the solute will decrease, because colligative property is inversely proportional to M solute. So when I increases more than 1, then it is the case of dissociation. Here colligative property increases, but molecular mass of the solute decreases. If I is less than 1, that is association, that is acetic acid dissolve in benzene. Acetic acid form dimer. So it forms dimer. So in dimer, so its Van't Hoff factor become 0.5. So in this case, association, the colligative property decreases, the molecular mass of the substance of the solute increases. So what happens? The effective atomic mass of acetic acid is 120, not 60. So I is equal to 60 upon 120, that means 0.5. So Van't Hoff factor for acetic acid in benzene is 0.5. Van't Hoff factor for benzoic acid in benzene is 0.5. Suppose NaCl undergoes dissociation, so its Van't Hoff factor for complete dissociation that will be 2, because it breaks into Na plus and Cl minus. So the 1 mole particle converts to 2 mole, colligative property increases, molecular mass decreases. Ideal and non-ideal solution and azeotropes, three topics we will see here. So ideal solution are those solutions which obey Raoult's law. So ideal solutions are those solutions which obeys Raoult's law. For such a solution, delta H mixing and delta V mixing is zero. Ideal solutions. So obeys Raoult's law. Obeys Raoult's law. For such a solution, delta H mixing is zero. Delta V mixing is zero. Non-ideal, very few solutions are close to ideal. In nature, there are no ideal solution, but there are few solutions which are very close to ideal, like benzene plus toluene. This is an ideal solution. Another ideal solution is normal hexane plus normal heptane. So they are very close to ideal solution. Now coming to non-ideal solution, they will not obey Raoult's law. For them, delta H mixing is not zero and delta. There are two types of non-ideal solution. Do not obey Raoult's law. For such a solution, delta H mixing is not equal to zero. Delta V mixing is not equal to zero. There are two types of non-ideal solution. One which show positive deviation from Raoult's law, another which show negative deviation from Raoult's law. So positive deviation, like ethanol, when acetone is added to ethanol, then it forms a positive solution, positive deviation from Raoult's law. Chloroform mixed with acetone show solution which show negative deviation. What happens here? Ethanol is already hydrogen bonded, but when acetone is added to it, it breaks some of the hydrogen bonded. So the solute can evaporate more. So the vapor pressure increases, which is more than what is calculated by Raoult's law. So it shows positive deviation from Raoult's law. Acetone and chloroform forms a unique type of hydrogen bond, due to which the escaping tendency decreases, due to which they show negative deviation. Azeotropes. Azeotropes are constant boiling mixtures of two liquids. So it is a binary solution. It is a binary solution of two liquids. Binary solution of two liquids. Two liquids which boil at constant temperature. Which boil at constant temperature. So like there are two types of azeotrope. One is called the minimum boiling azeotrope. Another is called the maximum boiling azeotrope. The example of minimum boiling azeotrope is ethanol water azeotrope, ethanol plus water. Here the composition of ethanol is 95.5% and that of water is 4.5%. So the boiling point is ethanol is 78.3 whereas water is 100 degrees Celsius. But the mixture boils at 78.1, suggesting that it boils at a lower temperature than the individual. Maximum boiling azeotrope is given by HNO3, water. Here the composition of HNO3 is 68%. So the mixture boils at more than the boiling point of water and HNO3. So this was all about solution chapter. One more concept that is generally asked. Suppose if you have been given a solute like K4FeCN6, suppose it dissociates, so it forms what? 4K plus FeCN6, 6 minus, 4 minus, sorry. So initially we start with 1, so it will be 0, 0. Suppose X breaks, so X, it will form 4X and it will form X. So total particle will be 1 minus X plus 4X plus X. So X is again, this is 1 plus 4X. So I will be equal to particle after dissociation, 1 plus 4x, particle before dissociation. So it will be equal to, simply we can say, I is equal to 1 plus 4x, or I minus 1 equal to 4x, or x equal to I minus 1 by 4. So here x is to the degree of dissociation. So we can find the degree of dissociation based on this. So two formula you keep it in mind. Degree of dissociation is I minus 1 by N minus 1. Another formula of degree of, this is the case of dissociation. In case of association, degree of association is I minus 1 by 1 minus N, 1 upon N by minus 1. So this is the case of association. So this was about the solution chapter. So solution, what you have to keep in mind, how to solve the problems based on molarity, molality and normality, how to solve the question based on concentration unit as well as Henry's law. Questions based on colligative property will definitely be asked. Particularly you must know the theoretical concept like reverse osmosis, how to find out the osmotic pressure by using, and this osmotic pressure measurement is best done for biomolecule, for determining the molecular mass of biomolecules and polymers which are very stable at room temperature. So this was about the solution chapter. I hope you understood, student.